You know, when we think about archaeology or we watch TV programs about archaeology, what do we think about or see? It's the rarest, the oldest, the most massive, the most aesthetically pleasing. Things like tombs and pyramids and beautiful crafted items of gold or the rarest minerals. But the size and attractiveness of archaeological remains don't mark their importance for understanding the past, which is what archaeologists want to do. Extremely small or frankly, even microscopic remains from archaeological sites can help us understand how people lived in the past and why they lived the way they did. A case in point is archaeobotany, also called paleoethnobotany. It's the study of plant remains from archaeological sites. Most people would think that there really are very few plant remains found in archaeological sites. After all, plants degrade in archaeological sites often are hundreds, if not thousands of years. But in fact, plant remains are very common in archaeological deposits. And there are lots of different kinds of plant remains that you can find in archaeological sites. In fact, you might argue that for most archaeological sites have plant remains, and those that don't are the exception to the rule. They're very small plant remains, pollen, spores, and things called phytoliths, which are granular pieces found in some plant parts. There are larger plant remains, including things like seeds and fruit and wood, as well as fibers in weaving. There are also residues of plants that you can find in archaeological sites, attached to pottery, for example. Plant remains can tell us much about how humans lived in the past and answer really important questions about the past and why people lived the way they did. What did they eat? How did they make or use utensils for everyday activities? What woods did they burn to keep warm and to cook their food? How did they construct their houses and other buildings? And how did plants fit into their religious beliefs and practices? All of these are important questions, and plant remains can help us understand life in the past. Plant remains can also tell us how these people interacted with their landscapes. Did they affect their environment? People manage their environments all of the time. The idea that there is this pristine environment unaffected by people is a rarity. People, for example, burn vegetation for hunting or to encourage new growth, which then has more abundant fruits, for example. Human groups, especially in temperate or cold areas, use an enormous amount of firewood to keep warm and to cook food. And do they, for example, after hundreds of years, do they denude the local forest for firewood? And so it tells us about the landscapes and people's interaction. And so it's really important to look at human plant interactions in the past, but they can also have value for the future to help us better understand how life will be in the future and how we may be able to be more resilient and adapt to changing conditions. One of the greatest legacies that our ancestors have left us, it was a corpus of a tremendous amount of agricultural foods. The origin of agriculture is one of the major transformations in the human condition, and our ancestors developed hundreds, if not thousands, of different kinds of crops. Unfortunately, nowadays, just a handful of crops feed the world, and in fact, three, corn, wheat, and rice, provide about half the calories for humans today. That is, we're putting all of our eggs into one basket. It's a very dangerous strategy. People have been worried over the last 100 years about getting enough food and to preserve the kinds of ancient crops and little known crops that people throughout the world are growing so that we have as abundant a basket of to deal with increasing population, feeding increasing population with climatic uncertainty that all of our future generations will have to deal with. Archaeology fits in here in that there are literally dozens of ancient crops known only from the archaeological record. And so if you want to expand the base of crops, we should consider ancient ones that could be redomesticated. And they may help ensure an adequate food supply for our grandchildren's children and later generations. So for example, in the eastern United States, there are a whole variety of plants that the ancient peoples cultivated before corn, beans, and squash became the important foods. And these were discovered only and known only from the archaeological record, and yet their ancestors still exist and they may be redomesticated. So in short, all artifacts, even those that may be very small or, hey, even ugly, help us understand the story of humans' past and may help us ensure that we'll have a reasonable future.